You know, there are American heroes who don't like this idea. Neil Armstrong, Gene Cernan have both testified against commercial spaceflight and the way that you're developing it. And I wonder what you think of that.
I was very sad to see that because those guys are, yeah. You know, those guys are heroes of mine, so it's really tough. You know, I wish they would come and visit and see the hardware that we're doing here. And I think that would change their mind.
They inspired you to do this, didn't they?
Yes.
And to see them casting stones in your direction.
It's difficult.
Did you expect them to cheer you on?
Certainly hoping they would.
When you had that third failure in a row, did you think, I need to pack this in?
No.
Why not?
I don't ever give up. I mean, I'd have to be dead or completely incapacitated.
T-minus 20 seconds.
Stage 2 tanks pressing for flight. Flight computer has control of the vehicle.
Do we see anything on the sensors that's a problem?
Sound right now,
nothing. Go for launch.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
A friend of mine has got a great saying about creating a company. Which is trying to build a company and have it succeed is like eating glass and staring into the abyss.
When something is important enough, you do it even though the odds are not in your favor.
Work hard, like, I mean, every waking hour. That's the thing I would say, particularly if you're starting a company. And I mean, if you do simple math, say like, okay, if somebody else is working 50 hours, you're working 100, you'll get twice as much done in the course of a year as the other company.
And then just work like hell. I mean, you just have to put in, you know, 80 to 100 hour weeks every week.
People who've been in the rocketry business for decades,
yeah,
who say about you that you don't know what you don't know.
Well, I suppose that's true of anyone. How can anyone know what they don't know?
But when critics say you can't do this, your answer to them is,
we've done it.